Okay. Thank you, organizers, for inviting me here. It's very pleasant to speak here. I'm going to describe a series of results partially published in joint paper. It's a big joint project with Tatiana Sherbina from Princeton University. And the title is, as it was said already, local eigenvalue statistic with band matrices, but I'm going to speak about some special approach, and this is the second title, transfer operator approach. So first, what is a band matrix? The simplest example of the band matrices is the model when we have zero outside to the central 2W plus one diagonal, and on this diagonal up to the symmetry condition, you have IID random variables with zero mean and variance 1/2W. So to have in each line, in each column, the total variance equal to one. And we will be interested in the limit when W tends to infinity, and of course n tends to infinity and then bigger than W. We do not consider the case when W is proportional to n. So W to n tends to zero. And I would like to say from the very beginning that it is expected that this model has crossover when W square is proportional to n. So it is interesting to consider W square near n square. And before, less than or more than n squared. So this is the simplest case, as I told already. There is a more general definition of the band matrix model. Then it's not necessary to have zero outside of some diagonal, but we put some, okay, still IID random variables with zero means, but the variance depends on the distance, and it is some scaling in the, it is some scaling in this distance, and here J of X some summable function, and of course if you put here step-like function, then you obtain the previous model, and our model, and this is the only the case which we can do for this type of band random matrices is when the variance is here, and it is some problem of the methods which I will apply. And here we have expression like this. So it's very similar. And another one type of band matrix which I'm going to consider is so-called block band matrices. And okay, it's in some sense it's a Wegener model. Wegener model is more general, and okay, here we have in this block we have n block on the main diagonal. N capital is dimensionality, and it is proportional to nw. W is dimensionality of each block. We have zero outside of all block. Here is GUE independent with the variance 1 minus 2 alpha over W, and alpha is a parameter less than 1/4. Here is Gnibor type, independent, identically distributed, but not symmetry. Of course, there is symmetry condition between this and this because we have Hermitian matrix. And okay, here crossover is expected for W square proportional to N also, but since N is N times W, then here we have crossover for W is proportional to N. So this is a definition of two model which I'm going to discuss. And now some results about global regime. Global regime was studied many years ago. The first results was due Malchanov, Harunji, Pastor, 92, and they proved that integrated, okay, joint eigenvalue distribution the first correlation function of the joint eigenvalue distribution converges to semicircle for any rate of W and N. More recent result is a central limit theorem, but there is also no crossover. You have that the fluctuation of the linear eigenvalue statistic for smooth enough function H converges to the normal random variables after proper normalization. Here we should put this normalization, but with this normalization, it does not depend on the rate of W square more than N or less than N. It's a difference from the previous result of Soshnikov. Okay, and the main object will be, the main point is spectral correlation function. As usually in the randomatics theory, the spectral correlation function is just marginal densities of joint eigenvalue distribution. So we take joint eigenvalue distribution and integrate with respect to variables starting from k plus 1. And if we study the local regime, then we take some, if we study the local regime in the bulk, then we take some point E in the bulk. Here is bulk from minus 2 to 2. And consider the lambda 1 and so on, lambda k in the neighborhood. And here is a good normalization, and study the limit when n tends to infinity for this correlation function. Now, okay, I'll say that the model has GUE statistic if for correlation function I have this determinantal representation for the correlation function in the limit. And I will say that the model possesses Poisson local statistic if the same limit has, after with a good normalization given like this, has the limit 1. And I'm not going to speak much about localization and delocalization, but some results were connected with this fact. And so, in fact, it is believed widely that, okay, Poisson statistic and Gaussian statistic is, there is connection of the statistic with localization and delocalization. That is why I prefer to do definition which I would like to have. And here we take some eigenvectors, which of course is random. We take, it is normalized, and we take the sum like this with S bigger than 2. And of course, if we have model like GUE, it will be 0, because in this case, W to have normalized, we have to take psi j equal proportional to 1 over square root of n. So for S equal 2, it is 1, but for bigger, it's 0. And if this condition is not true, then this vector is called localized. And I don't speak about exponential localization differently from the Anderson model, but normally if we have localization, we have something like this. Okay, and the main point of attraction, at least for me, in this model is so-called Anderson transition for random band matrices, because it is expected that when, okay, the model, excuse me, please, maybe I will come back a little bit. This model, of course, could be defined for any D, not only in D equal 1. Then the picture, of course, will be not the same, but you put here D. So this, from the very beginning, this model is D-dimensional. But for D more than 1, there are only few results. And since I'm going to speak today mainly about D equal 1, I will not describes them, but anyway, there is dimensionality. And for conjecture is that for D equal 1, as I told before, there is crossover when W much bigger than N. We have GUE statistic when much less local Poisson statistic. For D equal 2, the crossover is when W square is proportional to logarithm, and for D more than 3, crossover is expected when W is some fixed constant, even some fixed constant. And now I will mention some results about D equal 1. The first was the result of Fyodorov-Mirlin. It is theoretical physics level of rigor, but they show the existence of crossover for W proportional, W square proportional to N, and then there are some mathematical results. First, Zironai by Schenker, who prove localization for this condition for W, then the result of Erdős-Knollys, Yao-Yin delocalization, the first case when W much more than N 6, 7, I recall that correct answer, W much more than N 1 half. Here for fifths, okay, there is also results of Tatiana Sherbina for Wegener matrices with fixed N. And this means that W is proportional to N. And there is results of Bourget, Erdős, Yao-Yin of 16. They proved GUE statistic for W is proportional to N. And the last paper, recent paper by Bourget, Yao-Yin, 18 years, they proved GUE statistic and delocalization for this condition. But I would like to stress that they consider the random band matrices of much more general type than I. Now, a little bit aside is the results of Sasha Sodin. He proved H universality, and here crossover is N fifths over six. Now, what is the main object which I'm going to discuss is so-called generalized correlation function. Here is a definition. It is just the ratio of determinant. And in the case of the first correlation function, we have the ratio of two determinant. And if we have the second correlation function, there are four determinant in game. And I would like to say that, of course, if we take the derivative with respect to parameter, for example, here, z1, and then put z prime equal to z, then, of course, we obtain the trace of the resolvent, so the first correlation function. That is why, and here we should take second derivative. That is why to study standard correlation function in this way is the same as to study this correlation function. And this correlation function we take because we use supersymmetric integration, Grassmann integration, and it is much more convenient when we have determinants because there are formulas for determinants. Okay, and if we are going to study local regime, again, we take E inside the spectrum between minus two and two, and here take some perturbation. And I would like also to add the correlation function of characteristic polynomial. It is not direct connection of characteristic, this correlation function with the spectral correlation function, but it is in some sense less difficult to study, but in other case, it demonstrates the same behavior with crossover and so on. So it's very good model just to try the methods. And okay, now for this correlation function, here delta equal to 1, 2, 1, 0, 1, and 2 corresponds to the correlation function for determinants. And okay, here, first correlation function and the second correlation function. Anyway, we have representation of this form. And here, k delta are some kernels, rather complicated kernels, I would like to say. The variables which are inside the kernels are, in the case of delta equal 0, it's just two space variables and unitary matrix. In the case delta equal to no unitary matrix, two space variables. For delta equal 2, we have four space variables, unitary group, and also a hyperbolic group. Here is the definition of hyperbolic group. And everywhere dx means the integration with respect to x. And of course, the most important that there is a form like chain of this operator. That is why we need special form for variance. Okay, and what is the idea of transfer operator approach? It's just general property that if you have some integral representation like before, then we can consider the compact integral operator with a kernel k of x1 and x2, and then this integral is the result of the application of this operator to our vectors f and g. And using the spectral theorem, of course, you can write this like this, where the coefficient Cj are expressed in the term of eigenvectors, and lambda j of n minus k is j's eigenvalues of the operator k. Okay, the idea looks very attractive, but so in the previous slide, you can see that if we know spectral property of the operator K, then we know our spectral correlation function, generalized correlation function. But what? It is not so beautiful in life like in the picture because there are many difficulties. And first of all, of course, this operator depends on W also. And they are not self-adjoint. So if we are studying, we have big parameter, and the nice idea to use perturbation theory, but if operator are not so self-adjoint, specialists could say that it is not so pleasant to apply it. So you need to introduce some other methods to do this. For me, also a big difference that there is integration with respect to this, okay, not so unitary, but hyperbolic group, which I don't like so much because, okay, for example, the Laplacian operator, the spectrum of Laplacian operator on this group does not start at zero, which is very inconvenient when you study because intuition is against this. Okay. One more difficulty is that, in fact, this k are not just kernel, scalar kernel. They are scalar kernel only in the situation of k0. And if we have k1 and k2, in the case of k2, for example, your matrix kernel is 2/8 times 2/8. Using the symmetry condition, you can reduce by 70 to 70. It's better, but anyway, not so pleasant. And also the problem that the zero order of this matrix, which is very easy to find, contain Jordan type matrix. And again, to apply the theory of perturbation, and also very inconvenient to have Jordan cells. And maybe the main problem is that our integral representation contains in front of integral For R2, for example, it is W square. So you cannot take only just zero term of our operator, main term. You need to take also first order with respect to W and the second order with respect to W and prove that zero order and first order do not contribute. And the first zero order is rather simple, it's just the product of four 2x2 matrices. It's not so difficult, but in the situation for the first order, it's rather complicated. And with this term, okay, no hope at least for me to compute them directly, just to use some trick to show that they are of the form which I need. So, since we have all these difficulties, we did step-by-step project. On the first step, we study characteristic polynomials because it is the simplest case, but it demonstrates the same transition. And here we can do all. So we can prove GOE statistic here. We can prove Poisson statistic, and we also can study also the regime when W square is proportional. It's a recent paper of Tatiana Sherbina. And the case of density of states, in this case, we have two Grassmann variables, but no unitary. Here is no Grassmann variables. And here, two Grassmann variables, but no unitary hyperbolic group. And here we can show local semicircle. There is also sigma model approximation. It's, I don't want to explain exactly what does it mean, but it's some approximation for the second correlation function, and physicists believe that it demonstrates the same behavior like a standard correlation function. And here we can prove also universality regime. It's last year paper, and finally the second correlation function. So we have unitary group, hyperbolic group, four space variables, eight Grassmann variables. That is why the matrix is 2, 8 times 2, 8. And we can prove now universality in this form. Is W much bigger than n log 5n? Sorry, here should be, no, 5. If here is W squared, then 5. Okay, now let me say a few words about our approach. In fact, it's not so convenient to use directly spectral analysis. Much more attractive, again, at least for us, to use resolvent approach, which means that for this integral, for the integral representation of this, this is a first, second, or zero correlation function, we use a Cauchy formula, and here is the resolvent of our operator. And the idea is, okay, it's, we cannot prove that, for example, in the case of zero, this operator is tensor product or something like this, which would be very convenient for us. But we defined asymptotic equivalent operator when the resolvent is, in fact, very close on the special contour containing all eigenvalues. Not for, if we write here all that, of course, it will be the same that, okay, some operator one is almost the same as another. Here is this resolvent equivalence, and using this definition, I can explain you the mechanism of this crossover, very simple in the example of the crossover for R0. In this case, we are able to prove that our operator K0 is just a product, tensor product equivalent to the product of two operator, and this operator acts on the unitary group and this on the space variables. And since we have the same factorization for the F and G, then we obtain finally that our function could be written in this form. And if we divide by some normalization term, we obtain that we need to study only the behavior, because this operator does not depend on our xi, this one. Dependence on the xi only in this operator. So since this term does not depend on site, it is the same in numerator and denominator, and then we obtain the expression like this, and you can study only the operator k star. And about k star, a good news that it is self-adjoint. Much more good news that we know all eigenvalues and all eigenvectors of it. Because it's a difference operator, and if we take irreducible representation, it commutes with the shift operator, and if we take irreducible representation of the shift operator on the unitary group, then it commutes with the projects on this operator, and okay, so we have that our operator have, it is independent on this T in the sense that eigenvectors does not depend on T and does not depend also from this. It depends only on this form that it is a diff, in some sense, ratio of U1 by U2. And okay, we obtain that this operator is good self-adjoint, and we add to this some perturbation. And here we have when J is equal to zero, of course, the first eigenvalue is one. And here if J is at least one, we have spectral gap proportional to one over W square. And perturbation here is multiplication operator by some function. So we have self-adjoint operator, spectral gap is proportional to one over W square, and perturbation is proportional to one over N. Now, if W square is minus two is much bigger than, so the spectral gap much bigger than perturbation, then of course we will have, you can use perturbation theory, the zero eigenvalue will be like this, and here this product is zero, therefore the first eigenvalue is just one. And for the second, as I told before, there is a spectral gap of W square minus two. Now, we obtain that in the limit, we of course, we have the projection of this to the eigenvalues, eigenvectors corresponding to this eigenvalue. And if we do this correctly, we obtain this. And here, since I told that the first eigenvalue does not depend on xi, we obtain one. Now, what is the mechanism for GUE behavior? Assume now that our spectral gap is much less than the perturbation. Then it is not difficult to prove that unperturbed operator when xi is equal to n tends to the unit operator in the space which we are interested in, and then we have that our operator has a form here, some unit operator minus two n minus one, and here some another operator. It's not so important which one, but in from this formula it follows immediately, then we have this representation. Because we just need to put this expression in nth degree, and we obtain what we want. And then there is a resulting expression, which is sine p xi over 2 p xi. It's the same like in GUE case. Okay, and let me say a few words about the case when W squared is proportional to n. And here, if you analyze more carefully what is the behavior of k star of xi, then you see that it is still this one. And here, okay, the first perturbation is proportional to n minus 1 and is proportional also to Laplacian operator. Here is the expression of the Laplacian operator on the unitary group. And here are some multiplication operators. So, okay, after some work, you obtain that your correlation function have this form. Okay, now let me formulate the result more precisely. So the first one was by Tatiana in 14. And she proved that if n is much less than W squared minus theta with arbitrary theta, then in the bulk case, we obtain this sign kernels. The next result was joined in 2017, and we proved. And we proved that if n is much bigger than W squared, then the second correlation function is 1, so it's Poisson statistic. And the third one is the case when we have proportionally, n is proportional to W squared, and then the answer which I explained above. Okay, now what about the more general model? In the case of first correlation function, in fact, not so many problems. It's just some way to do some training in this technique. Because you can, here there is no unitary group. There is only integration with respect to space variables. Here the spectral gap is much bigger. And because it is O of W squared, and we obtain that for any n bigger than W, but this condition is okay, because I said that n over W or W over n tends to zero from the very beginning. It could not be bigger, W could not be bigger, but can be proportional. So we exclude only the case of proportional, and we have universe. We have uniform convergence of the first correlation function to the semicircle law with this rate. Now a few words about sigma model. What does it mean? In sigma model, in fact, we need to write our integral representation for the second correlation function and do in this representation some additional limiting transition. By the way, it's also a new result because physicists just write this model without any explanation why it is the same. So we proved that after some special transition, we obtain that our correlation function can be written in this form, and here it is written in the language of supermatrix, which means that diagonal block of the first order with of the second order with respect to Grassmann variables and of diagonal are Grassmann in the odd order. So we have these supermatrices, and integration is with respect to unitary matrix, hyperbolic matrix, and these four Grassmann variables. And again, it was the case just to see what will happen in general model, because without this, I cannot imagine that it is possible to understand what is the structure in the limit for the standard correlation function. Now, what is the result of this sigma model for the second correlation function of this sigma model? There is new parameter beta, and we expect that crossover is when beta is proportional to n, and we obtain this universality conjecture. That means that we prove that the second correlation function is for this random band block matrix with, here is written for which alpha, in the limit, then we obtain that there is second correlation function which corresponds to GUE. And again, here is a block, main block, and this block is also not so pleasant to study convergence to this. There are a lot of, okay, in the very beginning, you have much bigger matrix, and all coefficient of this matrix depend on here U and S, and in the standard model also of space variables. Now, sigma model in some sense legal way to get rid from the space variable, obtain only dependence on unitary variable and hyperbolic variable. So here is the result for sigma model. I would like to stress that it was technical condition that E between square root of W and minus square root of W. Now we get rid from this technical condition. So in fact, we can now do the same for the whole spectrum, because whole spectrum is from minus 2 to 2. And final results. Okay, in this case, we can prove something very similar to the sigma model, but in this case, we have only 6 times 6, only it's good. Then we obtain that for any E in the bulk of the spectrum, and if we have this expression for this restriction for W, then the limit of the second correlation function is, okay, corresponds to the GUE case. And I would like to say this work is in preparation. In fact, I think that we will put it in archive in a week or two. And for me, maybe it was the most, okay, complicated and huge paper in my life, because structure very complicated and very many places. Okay, each point, maybe each step is not so difficult, but there are huge number of these difficulties, and to overcome all this and to do the paper readable, it was really very hard for us. So thank you.